हरे कृष्णा। सो ऑन दिस मोस्ट ऑस्पिशियस ओकेजन ऑफ श्रील प्रभुपाद्स 125th व्यास पूजा, सो आई वुड लाइक टू ऑफर सम वर्ड्स ऑफ ग्लोरिफिकेशन। ऑल्दो इट इज़ मोस्ट आई नो दैट इट इज़ मोस्ट इनसिग्निफिकेंट टू ऑफर एनी वर्ड्स इन ग्लोरिफिकेशन ऑफ श्रील प्रभुपाद। एज श्रील विश्वनाथ चक्रवर्ती ठाकुर सेज इन द गुरु पूजा सॉन्ग दैट एबे जस घुसुक त्रिभुवन, दैट द ग्लोरीज ऑफ the pure devotee spiritual master has spread into all the three worlds. And we see that Prabhupada himself not only brought Krishna consciousness, he gave us the most unique gifts, and he has given us such gifts. Like the most specific thing that I really appreciate is that Prabhupada brought into Krishna consciousness the appreciation for spiritual master. None of the acharyas or none of the spiritual movements before had brought such thing. Like Prabhupada introduced Mangal Aarti, in which before glorifying Supreme Lord we glorify Guru, because Prabhupada knew that only by dedication to Guru one can achieve Supreme Lord, and he himself exemplified in his life. And this quality of his dedication to spiritual master and his tremendous faith in the holy name is actually the essence of all his preaching. So recently when I was reading Prabhupada Lilamrit a few months back, so I came across one pastime in New York which was very, very touching to my heart. So it was Prabhupada's last visit to New York, and Prabhupada was very physically very weak, and devotees were requesting Prabhupada, please stay back. So I'll just recount the pastime. So His Holiness Rameshwar Maharaj, he was telling Prabhupada, please reconsider, stay back. And some other devotees were telling Prabhupada, please stay back, take some rest, take some few months of rest. So Prabhupada had been very jolly till that time, but suddenly Srila Prabhupada's mood changes, and Prabhupada turned towards all the devotees, and his eyes were extremely deep. And more than ever before, he looked as if not being from this material world. And he says, I want the benediction to go on fighting for Krishna, just like Arjuna. So when I was reading this pastime, actually the hair, literally speaking, I was very touched, and hair on my body actually stood when I was really reading this pastime. So this shows Srila Prabhupada's intense desire, intense greed to preach Krishna consciousness for the pleasure of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and all acharyas. So, and when I was reading this Lilamrit, one more pastime I was reading, that when Prabhupada was there in Mumbai, so he was in his last few months of his pastimes on this planet, so he was very physically very weak, and he was not able to come down for darshan, he was not able to come down for classes. So the devotees in Mumbai were very, very pained that Prabhupada is not giving his association to us. So one fine day, without giving any pre-information, Prabhupada comes down and he understands the mood of the devotees. And Prabhupada tells, I am so sorry that I am not able to come down to give darshan, I am not able to come down to give classes, not able to meet devotees. But I want to serve all of you, I want to cook for you, I want to feed you, I want to come and give darshans. So now on, I will come every day, and at 8 a.m. in the morning, I will give darshan, I will give class. So when I was reading this pastime, so I was so touched that Prabhupada, even at such an advanced age, he was having so much concern for devotees' life. And he was traveling here and there. Even on the verge of leaving his body, he went to London. So I was very touched by reading such pastime. So it is actually Prabhupada has given himself personally, and he wanted to give the principle of Guru as an eternal personality. So that's why he stressed on Guru Puja. On that fine morning when he came without informing, He instructed the devotees the importance of Guru Puja. So it is very, very inspiring for my life. So Srila Prabhupada has given everything that is needed for a living entity to achieve perfection in one's life. So, but as Srila Prabhupada writes in Ishopanishad, ही टेल्स दैट ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ इनकम्प्लीटनेस आर एक्सपीरियंस्ड ड्यू टू इनकम्प्लीट नॉलेज ऑफ द कम्प्लीट होल. So Prabhupada has given everything in his books, in his teachings. So it is Prabhupada's tremendous mercy. And I will tell little bit about myself, that as I have been very fortunate to have the association of devotees for last many, many years, but I am very foolish in my practice, that I have not been practicing very sincerely. So I have not taken the association of devotees very sincerely. Even after getting initiation, I have not chanted sincerely. So currently I am blessed to be part of this Brahmacharya Ashram in Pune, and I am engaged in some insignificant service in Pune and in Jabalpur. So on this most auspicious occasion of Srila Prabhupada's birth anniversary, I pray at his lotus feet, that I read his books regularly, and hear his vani regularly, and take benefit of that, and take to the chanting of holy names very sincerely, as Prabhupada had so much stressed on that. And the association of Vaishnavas, like Prabhupada writes in Nectar of Instruction, that he has created this association of Vaishnavas to enhance the exchange of six loving exchanges. So I pray at his lotus feet that I take this association of Vaishnavas with sincere heart, and see devotees spiritually, and take their association with full heart, and develop a mood of respect and service. And although I don't have any ability to preach, I don't have any purity, only by mercy of Srila Prabhupada I'll be able to practice something, and I'll be able to share something to all people by distributing his books and distributing the message what he has given in this book. So if I'll be able to give my life in full dedication to Srila Prabhupada, then that is actually the greatest mercy that Lord can bestow on my fallen soul. So with this I conclude and pray at lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada. Jai Srila Prabhupada. Hare Krishna.